Here comes the fascinating world of trivia, where even a right answer can catch you in a trap. On Trivia Trap! The juniors are ready, the seniors are set to play, and here's the host of Trivia Trap,
Thank you, and hello, everybody. Welcome to Trivia Trap. This is the game for those of you who'd like to know a little bit about everything. Now, Trivia Trap is played by these two opposing teams, and somebody today will have a chance to win a pot of gold worth $10,000. Over here, we have our juniors. They're all under the age of 30, and their opponents are seniors. If you've hit your 30th birthday on our show, then you automatically become a senior. We're going to meet our two teams right now. And the seniors, by the way, are the returning champions back for their third day. And let's begin with Haig.
My name is Haig Haydossian. I'm a retired aerospace engineer.
Welcome back. You guys have won over $5,000 as a team. Fran?
My name is Fran Estes, and I'm the director of admissions at Flint Ridge Preparatory School.
Oh, nice. And Pat?
Hello, Bob. I'm Pat Melton, and I'm a waitress.
And a lady who knows a lot about trivia, too. Our seniors on our show. Good luck to you today.
Thank you.
I know our new set of juniors over here ready to try to take your championship away from you. Let's see if they can do it. We'll begin with Denise.
Hi, I'm Denise Davis, and I'm a checker in a grocery store.
Good. And Eddie?
Hi, Bob. My name is Eddie Barb. I'm the student body president at El Camino College.
Nice to have you with us. Robin?
Hi, I'm Robin Goldie, and I'm a flight attendant.
Wonderful. Welcome, our juniors. Now, you met our teams. Let's play our game. We'll begin with our seniors, as we always do. And Haig, again, you have the job of making those first choices. I'll show you two rows of answers. And Haig, you must choose the row of answers you want your team to play for. Up on the top row, we find these answers. Taiwan, Switzerland, Grenada, the Vatican. On the bottom, seniors, I get no satisfaction, the pill, let's spend the night together and do it, baby. Haig, top row or bottom row?
I'll take the top row.
You don't want to do it, baby, huh?
No way. I don't know anything about do it, baby.
It truly is a senior category,
right,
Haig. Are you ready?
Right.
Here's your question. Only one of these countries is a member of the United Nations. Which one? Now, one of those answers up there is the right answer. What you must do as a team is eliminate the incorrect answers one by one until only the correct answer is left. If you can eliminate all three of them, it's worth $300 for your team. One of the countries is a member of the United Nations. Which one? I'll the incorrect answers.
I'll cut Taiwan.
Okay, for our seniors, let's cut the answer Taiwan. Good choice. Fran, you have to do the same thing. You must find another incorrect answer.
I'll cut the Vatican.
Can we do it? How about the Vatican? You're safe again. Pat, where's that look of confidence you always have? Let me repeat the question. One of these countries is a member of the United Nations. Which one is it? You must find the wrong answer in order to get to the correct answer.
I know Switzerland is neutral, but I don't know if they belong or they don't belong. I'm gonna cut Grenada.
You're cutting Grenada. That means that you think Switzerland is the right answer. For $300, can we cut Grenada? No, you cannot.
I'm sorry.
Grenada. Grenada is a member of the United Nations. Switzerland and the Vatican have observer status, but Grenada was admitted in the year 1974.
Yeah.
Two answers you cut that were incorrect, which means you got $50 for each answer. So seniors start off with $100, not bad at all. Best start you've had so far. We'll be back in just a moment with more Trivia Trap and give our juniors a chance to begin their time. Seniors started off with $100. Remember, it's the team that gets to $1,000 that wins the game and goes on to play for a possible $10,000. Welcome, juniors. Denise, you get to make the first choices. Let's begin now. You know what is on the bottom row? I get no satisfaction. The pill, let's spend the night together and do it, baby. Up on the top are these answers. Yo-yo, gung-ho, Peking, and ping-pong. Will it be the top or the bottom for the juniors?
We're going to take the bottom row.
You want the bottom row. Here's a question. When the Rolling Stones first appeared on the Ed Sullivan Show, the title of their song had to be changed because it was considered too risque. What was the title? Find the incorrect answers. Denise, cut one.
Okay, I am going to cut the pill.
For our juniors, how about it? Can we cut the answer the pill? Good start. Eddie again, find a wrong answer.
Great, I'm going to cut do it, baby.
Let's cut do it, baby. One wrong answer remains, Robin. The question when the Rolling Stones first appeared on The Ed Sullivan Show, the title of their song had to be changed because it was considered too risque. What was that title? Find the last wrong answer, your team gets $300.
Well, because Let's Spend the Night Together looks like it could have been risque, I'm going to cut that.
You're going to cut Let's Spend the Night Together. So you think that the answer is I get no satisfaction. For $300, let's cut Let's Spend the Night Together. That was the one. And for broadcast purposes, the Rolling Stones changed the title to Let's Spend Some Time Together.
Yeah.
But at that time, they would not let them say Let's Spend the Night Together on television. I just did, didn't I?
Yeah.
You got two wrong answers. You got $100. We're all tied up. As we go back to our seniors, Fran, the choices are yours now. Yo-Yo, Gung Ho, Peking, and Ping Pong. Sounds like I'm speaking some kind of a language.
Oh, yeah.
Bottom row, here comes some more. Pepsodent, Arid, Listerine, and Ivory Soap. Top or bottom, friend?
I'll take the top row.
You want the top row?
Sure.
Which of these is Chinese for work together? Which of those answers is Chinese for work together? Find the wrong answer, friend.
I will cut yo-yo.
Good idea. Let's cut yo-yo. That's right. You did good. You're safe, Pat. One of those is the Chinese word for work together. You must find a wrong answer, Pat.
I will cut gung-ho.
You cut gung-ho. Audience says you should not have done that.
I'm batting
neutral.
A million.
Can we cut gung-ho? I guess when I say that they're very gung-ho about that, it's the Chinese word for work together.
Yeah.
You eliminated one of those incorrect answers, so we'll add another $50 onto your total. Seniors, you now have $150, and let's go back over to our juniors. Eddie, the choices are yours. Pepsodent, Arid, Listerine, and Ivory Soap, and then these up on top. Gail, Holly, Burke, and Hamilton.
I'll listen to the audience. Let's go with the bottom.
You want the bottom one, sure. Remember, find the three wrong answers. Your team gets $300 to take a pretty good lead. Question, what product used an ad slogan, always a bridesmaid, never a bride? Always a bridesmaid, never a bride. Cut the wrong answers. Eddie?
Bob, let me cut Listerine.
See if you can. Cut the answer, Listerine, for the juniors. Fell right into the old trivia trap.
Okay.
That was the correct answer. Listerine's slogan, always a bridesmaid, never a bride. You didn't get any money, so you end up at the end of the first round with $100. Seniors out in front for a change at the end of the first round.
Yeah.
That's something new for you guys.
Yeah.
$150. We'll be back in just a moment to play our $1,000 trivia race. We never did get to Gail, Holly, Burke, and Hamilton. It's one of my favorite parts of the show because I get to play Trivia Trap with you. I'll ask you the question. Here it is. In the movie The Wizard of Oz, Judy Garland played Dorothy. What was Dorothy's last name? Is the correct answer Gail, Holly, Burke, or Hamilton? We'll be back in just a moment to give you the answer and to play our trivia race right after this.